Hi guys, I'm Nancy, and I'm going to show you how to solve an inequality. So an inequality is just any equation that has a greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, or less than or equal to sign instead of the normal equal sign. In this video, we're going to focus on linear inequalities. If you're looking for a quadratic inequality example, that's another video. If you don't know what I'm talking about, this is the right video for you. Here's a simple linear inequality example. 2x plus 3 is less than or equal to 11. For this one, you're going to solve it as you would an equality, a normal equation. Subtract 3 from both sides. So you have 2x is less than or equal to 8. Divide both sides by 2 so that you have x alone on the left side. And you get x is less than or equal to 4. And that's your answer for that simple inequality. Now let's look at a tougher example where it's different from a normal equality equation. Say you have negative 2x plus 3 is less than or equal to 11. First step, you do subtract 3 from both sides, and you have negative 2x is less than or equal to 8. Now, you are going to divide out to get x alone, so you would divide by negative 2, divide the right side by negative 2 as well. But here's the trick. In an inequality, if you divide or multiply by a negative number, you have to flip the sign in the middle. You have to flip the direction that your inequality sign faces. So in this equation, we divide out negative 2, that goes away. We get x is greater than or equal to, flip the sign, negative 4. And the reason we flip a sign is just because we divided by a negative number. So your answer, your final answer in this one is x is greater than or equal to negative 4. One more example. Say that you have negative 1/2 x plus 4 is greater than 7. First step would be to subtract 4 from both sides, so you'd have negative 1/2 x is greater than 3. If you want x alone in this equation, you would actually need to clear this fraction, clear the negative 1/2. The fastest way to do that is to multiply both sides by negative 2. Because if you multiply by negative 2, you'll clear the fraction, you'll cancel the 2 in the denominator. Now that would just leave you with x on the left side, but again, because you multiplied by a negative number, you have to flip the direction of the sign, of the inequality sign. So instead of greater than, we now have less than. This is very important because all your other algebra might be correct, but if your sign is flipped, you won't get credit. So in this case, we have x is less than negative 6. And that's your final answer. X is less than negative 6. So if you've been having trouble with these inequality problems, just remember, it's the same as solving for x in a normal equality, normal equation, except if you ever multiply by a negative number or divide by a negative number, you have to switch the direction of your inequality symbol. You don't have to switch the symbol if you're adding a negative number or subtracting a negative number, only if you're multiplying or dividing by a negative number. I hope this video helped you. If you are looking for something more complicated, like compound inequalities or quadratic inequalities, please look at my channel for some other videos. If this was what you're looking for, and it helped you, please click like below.